It seems like only yesterday that I walked these streets with my friends, laughing away, and now the city's in ruins and my friends are dead. I don't want to believe it, I can't. I think I need a doctor. Langrat is pale, his lips are trembling. He is seriously ill. Yes, I did know somebody. I think they were around here somewhere, the people I knew. He is so weak from his sickness, he's starting to ramble. Nothing useful can be gleaned from his muttering. Just don't leave me here. You'll be back, right? Right. The Moneybags Quarter, haven't been here in a while. Brody presses his lips into a line. Not to gloat at someone else's misfortune or anything, but it warms my heart to see their mansions burning. They bury their dearest cousins in silks and gold, but they can't spare a few coppers to pay an honest gravedigger for his work. Skinflints. Well, what's there to know? It's where all the rich folks used to live their cushy lives. You can sense the hostility in his voice. As for me, I didn't come here too often, unless I had business with the town hall. I'd stop by the bakery sometimes, buy some cream rolls for the kids on special occasions. Oh, I hope our good baker's alive still, and the fires have spared his shop. Halt. Who goes there? I'm warning you, we're ready to shoot. A portly gray-haired man with a crossbow in his hands is shouting at you from the window. You see a few more people huddling behind him, clearly civilians, but all likewise armed with crossbows. Who might you be? Friends or cultists? This is the town hall, not a soup kitchen. We're under siege here, if you don't mind. Every crumb of hardtack goes a long way. If you want to trade, then by all means, but don't expect handouts. We're holding down the fort to the best of our abilities. The gods have so far been kind enough to spare us from any demons, but we have had some cultists trying to get in. We gave them a few bolts for their trouble, but those sly miscreants could return at any moment. Fortunately, we have prepared ourselves accordingly. The magistrate nods at the barricaded doors. Before you make any requests, no, we are not accepting refugees, we couldn't even if we wanted to. As you can see, the entrance is blocked to the point where no one can enter or leave without the help of a construction crew. If you require assistance, ask the inquisitors, we saw their unit walk past our windows yesterday. No point in asking us. Terrible, but you knew that already. But if you want to hear some city gossip. The bureaucrat chuckles. Word has it that one highborn gentleman, I won't name names, but his is certainly known to all. Anyway, he threw a city day party that was so wild, he actually missed the demon invasion. Can you imagine? Waking up after a drinking session, not knowing what's occurred, and wondering if your spree from the night before is the reason why the city now lies in ruins. What a preposterous question. Can't you see that you're speaking to the legitimate authorities? Magistrate Pelvezili, at your service. The man looks down at you proudly. This is the town hall, you know. Not some roadside watering hole. You won't find any old rabble here. Ymir is cradling his crippled hand. Well, what do you say? Think we'll make it? You know, I really don't fancy dying, especially not in this place. Who isn't? You must be thinking I'm hiding something, maybe I caused some trouble in the past, stole something from somebody, or took the goddess's name in vain when I was hammered, not by a long shot. Clean as a whistle, I am, but it's all the same to those hounds. If they don't like your sorry mug, up on the bonfire you go. So I try not to catch their eye, and you should do likewise. A little off. Ymir wipes the sweat from his brow. I think I might have caught something. Hope it's not dangerous. Good luck to Yat.
Watch out for trouble.
Escaping from sight.
Please, focus. It's you or me. This fight won't be my last.
Do not hold back. Strike as one.
You're not a threat. You're an obstacle.
Magrigio, Turinos. Mosi Travis.
Resort to brute force!
Wounded.
Who's there? Get away. There's nobody home. I don't know anything. I've told you already, there's nobody here. Get lost.
I'll gut you!
Together we stand.
I always have the upper hand.
I will not falter.
I will not be trifled with.
Hey!
Not hold back. Strike as one. Our time has come. I will see this through. I stand ready.
Going down!
These magics should be used in other ways.
Let's try this way.
Let us not hesitate. Together we stand.
Watch out for trouble!
together we stand.
No mistakes.
You or me? Keep your calm. There are many roads to success.
Yes.
I'll just have to resort to brute force!
Let's try this way.
Do not hold back!
You're not a threat. You're an obstacle.
Go.
I will see this through.
Thank you.
got you!
Strike as one.
Be carried out.
A treat is by the highborn and powerful ruler, His Excellency the esteemed Count Bartolo Mazinas. West Crown Royal Publishing. Approved by the censors of Kellyx. Below is a red stamp that reads, banned by the censors of Mendef. From time to time, we see some politician unacquainted with warfare but driven by false humanity propose an absurd thought, that wars are somehow supposed to be fought in the open field, away from cities, and only between professional armies so as to avoid casualties among so-called non-combatants, even if they are on the side of the enemy. The supporters of this ludicrous belief must be mistaking war for a tourney where fighters clash in mock battles, their swords clanging against shields as they avoid striking at the stomach or the head for fear of inadvertently delivering a mortal blow, in other words, achieving what would be their goal in real combat. Unlike mock fights, real war is a continuation of politics that utilizes force with the purpose of establishing the dominion of one group of people over another. And since power is the origin point of all morality, it goes without saying that no moral standards that may be customary in everyday life can impose limitations on power struggles, for the victor will be the one who determines those same standards. When one wants to catch fish, one goes to the river, and when one wants to hunt game, one goes to the forest, the natural habitat of one's prey, where it feeds, breeds, and rests. So if the prey is a human being, where else is one to go if not to the city? The city is where laws are passed, deals are made, treatises are written, and songs are composed. While pursuing the goal of subjugating a hostile society, one must begin by attacking its cities instead of wasting time maneuvering one army around another.
Never stop learning.
Defeat is not an option. Attack!
Stab their backs.
So it comes to this.
Something's wrong with the spell here.
I will guide.
It's you or me!
This will hurt!
This is unexpected. I need to concentrate.
You again? You better watch yourself walking around here like that, we almost mistook you for cultists. The gray-haired man shakes his crossbow at you. Alright, let's take a look at what you brought us. The magistrate brings out a basket on a long rope.
We shall overcome!
Good day to you, if such a thing can still be had in a city. It's bad. Very bad. Langrat's face is pale, his eyes are sunken, his brow is sweating. He is at death's door. Please, don't let me die here. Langrat takes a deep breath, then exhales. You see color returning to his cheeks. That really helped. I feel fine. Thank you. I do, yes. I don't know if any of them survived, though. My old friend, White's Tamil, lives in a house behind the town hall. Yes, and there's also the house of Reverend Draley, renowned patron of the arts, it's near the stables. If they still live, please kindly send them my regards.
Together we stand.
He's still alive? Oh, praise Shellen. Well, tell him I said hello back. Why have you come here? I suppose you need to go upstairs? Come in, I'll let you up. Come in, quickly. Are you sure you weren't followed? Oh, this whole thing's like a waking nightmare.
Watch out for trouble.
A battered-looking gnome wearing rags is waving at you with his bandaged hand. His hair and skin are halfway through the bleaching process and covered in specks of soot and dried blood. Despite his distress, he offers you a friendly smile. Where are you guys headed? Maybe we could go together? We're going where we're going. What's it to you? With a grim expression, Rikerth eyes the gnome and his companions, just as dirty and tattered as him. You go your own way. Hey, come now. That's no way to talk to people. Sendri gives the gnome the same wide grin back. We're looking for a safe way out of this quarter. Or just any way out, for that matter. We're homeless too, looking for a safe place, you know, one where nothing is burning, exploding, or snapping its teeth. I guess that's a luxury these days, but one can still hope. They look harmless, but there's something about their behavior that sets you on edge. While the gnome is busy smiling at you, his companion is shooting you looks that are far from friendly, and you could swear he's gripping something at his waist. Alright then, travel safely. The gnome's smile grows even wider, and weapons appear in his friend's hands as if by magic. Straight to the afterlife. In the name of Baphomet. I knew it. Every time, damn you all, it's the same thing every time. Rikert spits on the ground and reaches for his weapon.
Let's try this way.
Phew. Yeah, that does feel nice. Thank you, friend. I guess I'll live a little longer.
There are many roads to success.
Let's try this way.
Yeah.
Who are you? The heavily wounded fighter is bleeding out. Several crossbow bolts are sticking out of his chest. Cultists. Those scumbags have gotten bold. We should have done a better job of stomping them out. Northeast of here, in the cathedral, is the Inquisitor's post. You can get out through there. But getting to the cathedral, this area is teeming with cultists, and there's very few of us left. My people are fighting to the northwest of here. If they're still standing, find them. Make a break for the cathedral together. Tell them Captain Shue has ordered them to survive. His eyes roll back. He is dead.
Keep your wits about you.
Stand ready.